Amongst Luciferian organizations, there is a prophecy that if they can invade the Citadel, and that's their name for the Vatican, they will have power for 1,000 years.
How close are they?
Una vez
Very
más.
Close.
Once again,
siguiendo una tradición
following
de la
a tradition
que me siento honrado,
by which I feel honored,
el secretario general
the Secretary
de las
General
Naciones Unidas
of the United Nations
ha invitado al Papa
has invited the Pope to address this distinguished assembly
de las
of nations.
En nombre propio y en el de toda
In
la comunidad
my
católica,
own name and that of the entire
Señor
Catholic community,
representatives of the Hindu, Buddhist, Jain, Sikh, Native American, Jewish, Islamic, and Christian communities of New York City, our civic and public officials, and the board of the September 11th Memorial Foundation, I renew to you our welcome and our joy at your visit. Welcome, Holy Father. Sinners. We have many flaws. We make many mistakes. But one of the things we do very well is sincere and fruitful interreligious friendship.
In my own name.
More dead today in the worst flooding the Carolinas have ever seen. Officials say at least 17 have died, and they can't even begin to put a number on the damage done by an estimated 11 trillion gallons of water.
Unusually powerful tropical cyclone heading towards Yemen, of all places. The cyclone known as Chapala is showing some signs of weakening but remains a real threat in the Arabian Peninsula. Heavy rains, flooding expected when it makes landfall on Monday, and CNN meteorologist Tom Sater has been tracking the storm. And yeah, Yemen cyclone, it doesn't gel.
No, it doesn't. In fact, we went back to 1945 and looked at the records, and this is going to be the strongest, we believe, to ever make landfall. I mean, they don't have very many of them. If they do, it's usually Oman that gets hit. In fact, we went back to 1945 and looked at the records, and this is going to be the strongest, we believe, to ever make landfall.
Symbolizes the need of people to keep alive their sense of unity by means of just legislation. On the other, the figure of Moses leads us directly to God.
This is a shocker to a lot of people.
Yeah.
There are satanic practices going on
at the Vatican. Could that be true?
Yes.
You want to say that? If I was a lawyer and you were on the witness chair, I'd say, would you say...
It's out loud, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Now, when we say in the Vatican, it's at a certain level. And there's no doubt about it that there have been and still are practices that are formally venerating Lucifer, the prince of this world. There's no doubt about that. But there's no doubt about it that satanic or Luciferian practices, because it's really of the prince, that his name is Lucifer. It's really of the prince that these, in veneration of him and service of him, that these actions have taken place and do take place.
So, Father, is it because this is such a holy place that it makes it a number one target for Lucifer, or is it that there is a disease or a cancer within the Vatican, makes it sound like Watergate?
I'll tell you what I think, Art. It is that amongst Luciferian organizations, there is a prophecy that if they can invade the Citadel, and that's their name for the Vatican, they will have power for 1,000 years.
How close are they?
Very close.
What we have never found in the history of the Church since the ascension of our Lord. And that was when the Church was really set up, the Pentecost and the ascension, is that this is the first time we have undeniable proof that Satan has been enthroned in the Church by some of the Church's own churchmen. And that the Citadel, which before was besieged with small breaches in it and small little traitors, now has Satan enthroned within it. And, you know, Paul VI, who ended up a very miserable pope, in the end of his life he gave an interview to his great French friend Jean Guiton, who later published it when he died. And at one stage Jean Guiton said to him, Holiness, Sainteté, what do you think is the fate of the Church going to be? You have said that the smoke of Satan has in the Church and is wafting around the sanctuary altar. And Paul VI said, yes, he said, mon fils, my son, we have said that, and it is true. The smoke of Satan is in the sanctuary.
There is a prophecy that if they can invade the Citadel, and that's their name for the Vatican, they will have power for 1,000 years.
How close are they?
Very close. Very close.
But something must have happened, like, that would have caused, let's say, since the 1960s, for this organization to seemingly start self-destructing.
Auto-demolition. Yeah, there was this consecration, this enthronement of Satan within the Vatican, of Lucifer, by the way.
Now, did that actually happen?
Yes, it's a historical fact. It was done one particular day by a certain group of people representing Luciferians all over the world, especially American Luciferians. It was done, especially American Luciferians. It was done. And therefore, in a certain sense, Lucifer has power. He doesn't own yet, but I'm sure he hopes to own some pope as his man. I'm sure he does. And he expects to own some pope, not the present pope, but some pope, so that the house is really his.